Hey guys, it is your girl Jade Ashley, and I want to welcome you back to an all new video of When the Beat Drops. And like always, you know I'm here to give you my 5 hottest beats in music of this week, so of course you know you gotta stay tuned for more. Okay guys, so let's dive into this week's beats. So my first beat of this week, I have to talk about Carrie Hilson. Now if you guys are new to my channel, you probably don't know my feelings towards Carrie Hilson as far as like an artist, my love for Carrie Hilson, just the journey. So I'll just say real quick, if you knew me in high school, definitely you know I was the biggest Carrie Hilson fan. You guys know that I went to Performing Arts High School. I was a vocal major, so I used to literally be in class arguing with classmates on why Carrie Hilson is so dope. And it's been a very long time since she's dropped her album. She only dropped 2 albums. She had a debut album, sophomore album, which was In a Perfect World was the debut. No Boys Allowed was sophomore, and literally she ghosted us. Ever since, I was extremely hurt. I have a whole story behind what I went through to go get her last album, like all of that. But regardless of the fact, I reported to you guys not too long ago, in March to be exact, that Carrie Hilson said that she was coming out with new music on the 10-year anniversary of her debut album, In a Perfect World. She hit up Instagram and she pretty much let everybody know that in the summer of 2019 that she was dropping new music. It's September and we're literally days away from the first official day of fall, and there's no new Carrie Hilson music. And I was literally this close to hitting her up and like commenting. If you follow me on social media, I literally don't comment on anyone's stuff, like, so like maybe the people that I actually know, but like celebrities and stuff, like you will not catch me like commenting on their stuff. But I was literally this close to commenting on her page like, hey Carrie, what's up? Yeah, I know you said you're dropping new music in the summertime, you know, the summer's almost over, the first official day is September 23rd, so like what's popping? But before you know it even got to the official first day of fall, she pretty much let everybody know that there was going to be a delay with her new music. So she just made a simple post on her Instagram and she said in the caption, I don't share much, but I'm working my ass off to get you this project. Turns out I'll be a tad behind summer, but we're almost there. And all I know is that I better get a new Carrie Hilson. At least, I'm not even going like push it and be like a whole project, but at least a single. I need a single before 2019 is over. I feel like I'm being real nice, I'm being real lenient, but Carrie Hilson, I need this new music. I've been waiting. If you know me in real life and you knew me for a while, you know I've been waiting for some new Carrie Hilson music. So Carrie, you know what? I'm gonna excuse, you know, you missed the deadline. It's not the summertime. You say you're gonna be a tad bit behind summer. I'm gonna just give you to the end of the year, okay? So I don't know if you want to do fall time, winter time, you know, we got the fall and the winter time still happening in 2019. So as long as you give me at least a single before 2019 is over, I will be satisfied. Please come out swinging hard. You already got the vocals. You already got the pen game. So please, this is all I've been waiting for. This is all I want from you. So definitely let me know if you're a Carrie Hilson fan, because I'm definitely a Carrie Hilson fan. I can sing to you a whole bunch of Carrie Hilson music, and I've just been waiting for a very long time for this new music, and I need it to come out very, very soon. All right now, so we're gonna move on to my second beat, and we're gonna talk about J. Cole no longer doing features. So he pretty much announced the news when he was promoting his new single that he is featured on, which is Gangstar's new record, Family and Loyalty. Now, if you guys don't know, Gangstar is composed of the legendary MC Guru and DJ Premier, and they have a new record out called Family and Loyalty, and J. Cole is featured on the record. And while he was talking about the record, he pretty much just kind of let the bomb go that he is no longer doing features. So he said on Twitter, he was like, this is an honor to be on this song, new Gangstar. This is the last feature you'll hear from me. Thank you to everybody I got to work with during this run. This song is a classic. Thank you. Rest in peace, Guru. If you guys don't know MC Guru, he passed away back in 2010. But yeah, so J. Cole is not doing any more features. And the thing about it is, when you listen to a J. Cole album, J. Cole is known for going platinum without having any features on his, you know, projects and stuff like that. But recently he has been doing quite a few features. I know he was featured on 21 Savages a lot. I know he got a feature with Moneybagg Yo. I know when Moneybagg Yo dropped that, I was like, damn, Moneybagg got a, you know, J. Cole feature. Because to me, when I hear that J. Cole, because he, I definitely think is one of the best lyricists in this generation. So when someone gets a J. Cole feature, I think that's pretty, like a pretty big deal. So for someone who doesn't get features on their projects, but he does features for other people, like, I just thought that was so dope. But pretty much he's just saying that, yeah, he's not doing any more features. So his last feature that he did was on Gangstar's latest track, which is Family and Loyalty. And yeah, I don't know. Like, I don't know how I feel about that. You guys know that Dreamville, they dropped their Revenge of the Dreamers 3 this past summer. And yeah, I don't know if that counts technically, because, you know, Revenge of the Dreamers is something obviously that's not, it's not the first album. So I mean, he has like a whole label, he has a whole bunch of artists and stuff like that. So if he does like another Revenge of the Dreamers, is that technically considered a feature? Because I mean, it is his artist, it is his label under his, you know, Dreamville brand. Like, I don't know exactly how that works and stuff like that, but I do kind of feel bad for artists who may have not gotten a chance to get a J. Cole feature. Or if J. Cole decides to do a feature, I wonder which artist would it be for him to kind of do that with. Because, you know, we still have been waiting on that, like, J. Cole and Kendrick Lamar project. So I don't know if that would be considered a feature, but it's kind of like bummed out type of news. But yeah, y'all comment below, let me know your thoughts on J. Cole saying he is no longer doing features. But other than that, speaking of good music, we're gonna keep on, or new music I should say, we're gonna keep on going on and talk about K Michelle. She dropped a new record this week. So she dropped her new single Superhood featuring Cash Doll and Young Miami. Now I'm gonna keep it a buck with y'all and let y'all know how I really feel about this record. So first things first is I love me some K Michelle. I have every K Michelle album. The only project I don't have is Zero Fucks Given Part 2, and the only reason why I didn't download it is because I was mad at her at the time. But other than that, I have every K Michelle project. I can sing almost every record on her projects and stuff like that. So I'm a huge K Michelle fan when it comes to her music. So she did drop a new record. I'm always going to support when she drops music and stuff like that. So I listened to the track a couple of times, and the track is okay in my opinion. You know, it's a more up-tempo song and stuff like that. And you know, the song is pretty much talking about their love for hood dudes. Now I don't know, maybe I didn't resonate with it, because not that I don't like hood dudes, I guess didn't have a hood dude type of experience. You know, if y'all know how I be, if y'all seen previous videos, then y'all know. But yeah, so I don't know, maybe it's because I didn't resonate with the song and stuff like that. But like I said, the song is cool, it's dope or whatever, but I just kind of feel like this is just her getting her feet wet as far as like dropping new music. Like, you know, she's always, you know, on live and stuff like that. She's always talking about how she got a new project. Like, so we know she stays in the studio, we know she has tons of music. So I just kind of felt like this was just her, you know, getting her feet wet and stuff like that. Like, that's not the best of the vault. Like, I know she has some crazy records, you know, to put out there. I want to get the, you know, Kiss My Ass K Michelle, the Damn K Michelle, the Kiss Me Miss Me Goodbye K Michelle, the Pay My Bills K Michelle. Like, those are like some dope records from like her previous projects, and I just know she has it in her. I know she kind of wants to switch some things up, but this record is just okay for me. Yeah, it's just okay. It literally is just okay. I know that she already shot the music video for it, so she dropped the record. She said that the music video is coming soon. But if you have not checked out the record, I will definitely drop it below in the bio. And then you kind of could just let me know your thoughts on the record. Maybe I'm tripping. Maybe I need to just give it a little bit more time, let it marinate and stuff like that. But for right now, that record is just okay to me. I'm not too crazy about it. But other than that, we'll move on to my fourth beat of this week, and I have to talk about Mr. Kanye West. So Kanye, he broke a new record this week. For the first time, he has earned the number one spot on Forbes Forbes highest paid hip hop acts of 2019. He earned the number one spot with a total of $150 million. Now, the title was previously held by Jay-Z, but you know how he always looked up to Jay-Z. I don't know what their relationship is like now. That's first and foremost. But we know that he came up under Jay-Z. You know, he looked up to Jay-Z, all of this other stuff. They were family. And I'm sure regardless of whatever happened or whatever's going on with their relationship, they're still family at the end of the day. But yeah, so now Kanye West, he has a number one spot of Forbes highest paid hip hop acts with $150 million. Jay-Z does come in the number two spot with $81 million. Drake follows with the number three spot of $75 million. Diddy has the number 4 spot with 70 million, and then Travis Scott finishes out the top 5 with 58 million. And the list is actually 1 through 20. So, you know, your favorite acts on there, Nicki Minaj, you know, you got Childish Gambino, like, it's just a whole bunch of rappers are on there. That's first and foremost. And yeah, so a funny thing is that Meek Mill, he actually is number 15 on the list with 21 million. And he tweeted out, he was like, that Forbes got our bank accounts fucked up. So pretty much him and Cardi B had said something about like they just completely wrong and stuff like that. So I'm not exactly sure how Forbes actually, you know, kind of puts this whole thing together and stuff like that. I don't know if they missed the whole of 2019 part, so it's just for this year. I don't know if it's like a, you know, estimated amount and stuff like that. But yeah, according to Forbes, right now Kanye West is the highest paid hip-hop act for the year of 2019. So congratulations to him. You know, as far as like his whole music situation goes, you know, he does still drop music. You know, he's really heavy with his whole Yeezy brand. Right now he's kind of doing like this whole Sunday service thing, and I know he actually is coming out with a new album, which is Jesus is the Lord, or the Lord is Jesus, or something like that. Something with the something religious, obviously, because like I said, he's built real heavy with his whole Sunday service situation. But yeah, y'all kind of let me know your thoughts on, you know, Kanye West being the number one spot. Who do you wish to have seen at the number one spot? It's kind of like, who you think, like, I mean, the fact of the matter is it's based on the money that they make. So regardless of who you thought should have been number one, is whoever's number one or whoever's at the top of the list is based on the money that they make. But yeah, other than that, we're gonna move on to my last beat of this week. And I know y'all want to hear me talk about this whole Tekashi 69 situation, because you know he's been pretty much the highlight of this week with his whole case and him testifying and talking and this and that. And I'm gonna just keep it a buck with y'all and let y'all know my exact thoughts, and that is, I'm going to mind my damn business, okay? Yeah, we all have thoughts. Everyone has been, you know, kind of setting out their views on it. Pretty much a lot of people are kind of like against him at this point because he is looked at as like a really huge snitch and stuff or whatever. He's been name dropping. There's people that's been in the courtroom literally typing out word for word as far as like what he's saying. So he's been naming people such as like Jim Jones and Trippie Redd and all of this other stuff. But me, preferably, I'm just going to mind my business because it has nothing to do with me. Like, you know, we know people do a lot of crazy things for fame, and I'll just say that it's not worth it because y'all see his situation. So it's not worth it. Be yourself. Be happy with who God made. Don't be fake, and don't be a clout chaser, and just don't be extra. That's all I could say. That's all I feel about this whole situation, and that's on that. And yeah, so those are my 5 hot beats of this week. Okay guys, so I want to thank you for tuning into this week's video, and of course, you know I have to end every single video by reminding you guys to comment, like, subscribe, and share. It will greatly be appreciated. Now y'all know I cannot end this video without giving y'all my song of the week, and my song of the week is gonna have to go to Tory Lanez. Now this is kind of like a new song, but it's not like a new song. I first heard this song when I was on my way home from Vegas. Y'all know my last video was my last trip to Vegas, and I was listening to the Rap Life playlist on Apple Music. At first I was looking for the A-list hip hop and I couldn't find it, but then I think they replaced the A-list hip hop with the Rap Life or whatever. But yeah, so I was listening to that playlist, and like literally the first song that popped up when I put it on shuffle was this new Tory Lanez song, which is called Forever. And it's just so hard, like it was just bumping so loud and I was just feeling it, and that's like legit one of my songs that I constantly listen to on a daily basis. So my song of the week, Tory Lanez, Forever. Once again, thank y'all for tuning in, and I will check y'all next time. So bye. Hey guys, thanks so much for tuning in. Don't forget to share and subscribe, and I'll see you all next time.